Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I'll show you how to protect sheets in the React Spreadsheet component. I'll also show you how to protect the sheet with a password and how to unprotect it. First, I'll open my existing project where I have already installed the Syncfusion React EJ2 spreadsheet package and configured all the necessary spreadsheet modules. I have added the basic spreadsheet rendering code here. In this example, I have configured two sheets. I have mapped data to sheet 1 using cell data binding and mapped protected sheet data from data.js file to sheet 2. In addition to that, I have added the columns directive tag and also specified a custom width for individual columns using the column directive tag. You can refer to my React spreadsheet getting started video to learn about rendering the component. I've included a link to it in the card above and the description below. Using the created event, I have applied cell formats to the spreadsheet data. Before moving to the topic, let me run this application and show you the initial output. You will see the spreadsheet rendered with the provided data source and formats applied. First, I will show you how to protect the sheet. There are two ways. Click the Data tab in the ribbon and click the Protect Sheet button. Here I provide the password as Syncfusion. Notice here, the selection feature is chosen by default. You will be prompted to enter the password again. Check now, when I try to edit the cell, spreadsheet dialog shows the message the cell you are trying to change is protected. To make changes, unprotect the sheet. You can still do changes in the second sheet. Another way to do is to right-click on the desired sheet and choose the Protect Sheet option. Password is optional, so I leave it blank. Now I cannot do any changes here. There are two ways to unprotect a sheet. Click the Unprotect Sheet button in the context menu of the desired sheet, or in the Data tab. Since EMI calculator sheet is password protected, you will be prompted for password to unprotect it. Now I can do the changes to this sheet. I can also enable the protection feature on samples initial load. In EMI calculator sheet, I add the isProtected property and set its value to true. Check here, I cannot change any cell data in sheet 1. Editing, selection, formatting, insertion, and deletion functionalities are disabled now. You can enable a few like selection, formatting, and hyperlink using the Protect Settings property. I define the Protect Options variable and allow selection by enabling the Select Cells property for the EMI calculator sheet. Then assign this variable to the Protect Settings property of EMI calculator sheet. Check now, selection is enabled in the EMI calculator. Now I will enable all other options like cell, row, and column formatting, and hyperlinks. Checking now, I can apply background color to the selected range. Also, hyperlink option is enabled in the context menu. I'll insert the Syncfusion demo link. Next, I'll show you how to protect the sheet with a password using the spreadsheet built-in method. In the onCreated event, I call the protectSheet method using the spreadsheet instance. Here, I need to pass three arguments: sheet index, protectSheet settings, and password. To protect sheet 2, pass the index 1 and enable selection in the protect settings. I provide the password as Syncfusion. Check now, EMI schedule is protected and selection is enabled. To unprotect a sheet, I need to provide the password. An alternative is to use the unprotect sheet method and pass the sheet index as 0. Since I have protected the first sheet through cell data binding. Now, the EMI calculator sheet is unprotected. I can also unlock the cell range in the protected sheet. Notice the EMI calculator sheet is protected. and I want to unlock the cell range B1 to C9. In the onCreated method, I call the lockCells method, using the spreadsheet instance. Here I need to provide two arguments, cell ranges B1 to C9, and disable the isLocked property. Check now, I can only edit the cell range B1 to C9. Finally, to protect an entire worksheet, I use the Protect Workbook option in the Data tab and provide the password as Syncfusion. See, all the sheet operations are disabled. An alternative is to enable the isProtected property directly in the spreadsheet and provide the password as Syncfusion. See, all the sheet operations are disabled. In this video, I have shown you the options available to protect and unprotect sheet with password. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which gives you a free license key to use our React products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.